2004 about starting Kaleidoscope, reaching out to the music and the creative arts area of our society. And it took a step of faith for my wife and I to leave a big established church, leave a big established salary, amen, and take a step of faith and start Kaleidoscope. And we did. We prayed about it, my daughters knew about it, and we took the step of faith 12 years ago. We started, we hired the Nassau Auditorium. We had no offices. I was working out of my garage, which I converted into an office, because I knew that God had called me. I knew that there was a purpose. There was something that He wanted me to fulfill in Cape Town. And started Kaleidoscope. And about 2 years into us running at the Nassau Auditorium, there was a young band that wanted to come and perform one Sunday night at one of those events. And I had never heard of them. It was a guy called Jonathan Rubain, a guy called Don Vino Prince, a couple of other musos. And they stepped onto the stage. And you know, the amazing thing is, Rashid Lombard from ESP Africa, who was then part of the jazz festival, was sitting in the audience that night, and he had his little camera, and he was filming the gig. So we had a couple of musicians there, and within 2 years, Jonathan Rubain did the Cape Town International Jazz Festival. Don Vino Prince, then we met with Don Vino through Tony Schilder. Can you believe this? Tony Schilder needed a band one night at the Galaxy, and he asked me if I would come and sing and if I bring my band along, but he's playing piano and he's got a young saxophonist playing with him. So it was Tony Schilder, my band, plus Don Vino Prince. And that was, the rest was history. Don Vino then became part of the Glenn Robertson Jazzmen, and for 7 odd years was part of what we did, the recordings, etc., etc. And then Don Vino and Ronell had a baby. They lost that baby. And I was there at the hospital. We watched their beautiful little baby breathe her last breath of life. Stood with them. I've seen them take on more and more and more. Jonathan and Don Vino came and they did something here not too long ago. And it gives me great joy and great pleasure to introduce Don Vino Prince tonight, because we have built a wonderful relationship. And you know what? When there's something where you're going in this direction and I'm going in that direction and we're doing the same thing and we can walk together, then guess what? We must walk together. And I want to say to the music fraternity, we've got Gabby LaRue here, who is the head of MASA. He's the director of SAMRO. We've got Vicky, Vicky Leandros, but it's... we've got Vicky Sampson here. Let me tell you something. Cape Town doesn't know what is going to hit it. When the musicians of Cape Town stand up together under one banner, under Music Association South Africa, under the African Musicians Trust, under Arts Capital, under whichever organization, when these organizations can come together and not be thinking of their own agenda, but let's think of the young artists coming through. We have so many. There's young Timothy Ehrenreich, who normally plays here. There is Jared Peterson. I heard this young saxophonist. There's a youngster who said to me, Pastor, I just want to meet Joshua. Are you here? Joshua Davids. He begged me. He wants to meet Don Vino Prince. Like Don Vino wanted to meet Robbie Jensen. Wow. You know? Like Jonathan Rubain wanted to meet Mac McKenzie. And so it is with a joy in my heart that I first say, and we're going to pay tribute to the late great Errol Dias later tonight. But ladies and gentlemen, let's give an amazing round of applause to Don Vino Prince and his band.
Thank you.